Okay, answer number one. It's not. This is a trick question. It's actually not a trick question. Multiple app servers means multiple caches, and so we have to keep them in sync. Yes, that is one source of problems we are going to face. You know, we have multiple app servers. Let's draw a picture. We've got our database, and say both of these guys have their little cache here. You know, let's say both these caches are warm. They've got their stuff. Let's say a database, a post comes in here that results in a database write, which results in a refreshing of the cache. Now we've got one app server with an up-to-date cache and another app server with an out-of-date cache. And so if a read comes into here, we're going to get stale cache. And that's no good. So we've got to figure out a way of keeping these caches in sync. Each app server may have to hit the database to update its cache. You know, this is a problem. Let's say the situation is both of these caches are cold. They're empty. And two read requests come in, or many read requests come in. This is similar to the cache stampede problem, where each of these app servers is going to want to update its cache, which means it's going to have to hit the database. So that's problematic as well. Now, of course, we can alleviate, you know, some of these problems by updating the cache on writes, but we'd still have to find a way of, you know, keeping these guys in sync with one another, which is a little tedious. And the final answer will be caching data redundantly. I'm not accepting that one in this quiz as a bad thing, because very often you do cache data redundantly. That's kind of what a cache is, right? You're storing data redundantly. And I'm actually torn on whether this should be considered a downside or a plus side or kind of neutral. But for our purposes, we want to focus on these problems, which is keeping these caches in sync and limiting the number of database requests we do. Now, the solution we're going to approach here is going to change this architecture a little bit. Instead of each app server having its own cache, we're going to move caching into its own process. And so now both these app servers will use a shared cache. And so this cache actually behaves very similar to the database, except the queries are much simpler. They're just key value pairs, and it's probably only in memory. And there's technology designed specifically to solve this problem, which is to be fast and used as a cache, which is different from a database, which is designed to, you know, run complex queries on huge amounts of data. This piece of technology is called Memcached. And we're going to be spending basically the rest of this lecture learning how to use Memcached.